For the first time in history, a Filipino-American will be the head coach of a NCAA Division I basketball team. Mike Magpayo will lead the University of California Riverside men's basketball team in the upcoming NCAA tournament. The Highlanders compete in the Big West Conference alongside teams such as UC Irvine, Cal State Northridge, and University of Hawaii. To get to know more about Coach Mike, he now joins us on ANC.
Coach Mike Magpayo, thank you so much for joining us here in ANC. Congratulations on your new position as the head coach. First Filipino-American to be a head coach in the NCAA Division I. Coach Mike, thank you so much. Can you tell us on the story on how you landed this position?
Well, you know what? It actually happened pretty fast as far as just the last 2 weeks. I think my predecessor, David Patrick, Coach Patrick, got a great opportunity to go to Arkansas for one of his great friends and a former NBA head coach and Eric Musselman. So he took that position and it was a great, really huge opportunity for him. And so they decided to promote me here to the position. So obviously I'm excited. Thank you for having me, Migs. That's great.
Coach, for the benefit of our Filipino viewers, of course, basketball is a big thing here in the Philippines. So proud of the achievements of players and coaches landing big jobs, especially abroad. But can you tell us more about your background in your coaching career and your move to your stay in the States, and how is it like being a Filipino in the basketball world, of course, in the United States of America?
Yeah, I mean, I'm like my parents were born and raised in the Philippines and moved here. And I'm the first of the kids, the Magpayo kids, to be born here in the United States. But like every other Filipino, I grew up loving basketball. My dad coached me when I was young and played basketball my whole life growing up. And it's just something that is ingrained in all of us, right? We love hoops. And, I started coaching with my dad, actually, when I was 15. We were coaching my little brother's team, and I was just helping out, and I kind of realized, oh, I think I like it. I like coaching a little bit. And then, I graduated from college, and I was in the business world. But for the 9-10 years that I was in the business world, after graduating from UC Santa Barbara, I coached high school basketball. Just something I do from November to February during the season while I was running my real estate company. But I always dreamt of doing it at the, college level, at the Division I level. I just thought I could do it. And it's a long story, but I actually was going to get my master's at NYU in real estate in 2010, because we survived the real estate crash. Actually, our company came out the other side, and I wrote letters to all the colleges and all the coaches in New York City. And one responded, and his name was Kyle Smith, and he just got the head coach job at Columbia. He's now the head coach at Washington State, and he told me to meet him, and I ended up volunteering for him for a couple months, and he said, if you want to start, I'll start you here as director of operations. You start at the bottom, but you can't go to NYU, and you got to sell your company, and it was a dream of mine, and I did it. So that was 10 years ago. I jumped in, and the rest is history, the journey. I was there for 4 years for him at Columbia. Then I went to Campbell University in North Carolina. And then he brought me back to San Francisco. He was the head coach at University of San Francisco. And so I went with him there. And then 2 years ago, one of our friends, David Patrick, got the job here at UC Riverside. And he brought me down to start and build this program.
Wow, Coach, a story of perseverance and following your passion. You mentioned that you were in the real estate business, but still doing this on the side. But firstly, I just want to ask first, why didn't you pursue this basketball coaching on a full-time basis from the beginning to begin?
Sure, I would have. It's hard. What people always, like all the young coaches, they always ask me, like, how do I get in? How do I get in? And I always tell them the same thing Kyle Smith told me when I walked in his office. He said, don't do it. Don't do it. And it's more of a test. Say, you're not going to make any money. You're going to work all the time. You're going to work, 7 days a week, 24, whatever. You got all these coaches above you, or your boss is going to be telling you what to do. And it's really a thankless job to start, and you're not making anything. So if I could have made it and made money and had a career right away, but it just takes time. It's not that easy, not that possible. it just takes time, you know, it takes time. So I would have done it if I could have, but it was like, you know, and the business where I just was, you know, I graduated from with a business degree. And of course my parents wanted me to be a, you know, business owner. And I did. And that actually helped me, you know, that was just like coaching a team. It was coaching a company. It was very similar.
So that was very crucial, Coach, when you sent out those letters and finally won. Only took one to believe in you. And how is that, you know, maybe setting values at the same time, how was that a crucial point in your career that you're here now, head coach of UC Riverside?
Yeah, I mean, the story is, it's even funnier than I told, but it was a seminal moment in my life. I was, you know, again, it was 10 years ago. I was a CEO of a real estate company, pretty successful, like living a really comfortable life here in Newport Beach, Orange County, and Southern California. And I just chased. He gave me the opportunity and I jumped on it and I made the decision. And obviously today, and we can say it's worked out so far, you know, I got to coach a game first, but I couldn't have dreamt it any better than it's worked out.
Coach Mike, for the benefit of our Filipino viewers, because most of the content that Filipinos get to watch are the NBA and local collegiate basketball. When it's March Madness, when it's the NCAA, it's only high time when it's the Elite Eight, the Final Four, or the National Championship. And we know all those big names, right? Like a Duke, North Carolina, etc. But then UC Riverside, we've got to get some context on what kind of team you're coaching now. Now, how big is it that you're representing here in the Big West Conference?
Well, the Big West Conference is, and UC Riverside, you know, we're part of the UC system. So it's like arguably the best public institution, the UCs, UCLA, UC Riverside, UC, you know, UC Berkeley in the country. You know, it's great education and whatnot. But we're in the Big West Conference. So we're what they would call a mid-major program. You know, obviously the high major programs are Duke, North Carolina, Kentucky, UCLA, like you're saying. So we're a mid-major program, and we compete against other mid-major programs. But our Big West Conference, if you win the Big West Conference, you go to the NCAA tournament in the March Madness, like you're talking about. During the season, we still compete against a lot of those big schools. Like last year, we had a huge upset against Nebraska in the Big Ten Conference. In our first game, we beat them by like 18-20. They had former NBA head coach Fred Hoiberg. So we still compete against them in the non-conference. But in the conference, it's the Big West. It's like Hawaii, UC Irvine, UC Santa Barbara, Cal State Long Beach. That's our conference. And that's our goal, is to win the championship of that, the Big West, so that we can go to the NCAA tournament in March Madness.
Coach Mike, what is your coaching style?
Sure. You know, I lean defensively, and that's what I did the last year. I was responsible for the defense. I was defensive coordinator for all intents and purposes. And obviously Coach Patrick is a great coach, David Patrick. And, you know, he mentored me and taught me a lot, but I will lean defensively. I like being big. We're big. You know, we got 2 7-footers, 2 6'11" and 2 6'10". So 6 guys above 6'10". So we're big. I like to be big at every position. It helps defensively. We're a very good rebounding team. I think we were 9th best defensive rebounding team in the country last year. That's full NCAA. So we were 9th best, 10th best scoring defense. So we have the defensive fingerprint and blueprint. Offensively, we're going to use our size, you know, and play a little smash mouth type of style. But I really like to let the guys, give them a framework and concepts and let them flow offensively. I'll be more holding them accountable defensively and rebounding. And then I like to just let them flow and play freely offensively and get comfortable. And I will always lean towards playing shooting. You know, I'm a big proponent of that. So hold you accountable defensively, rebounding, and then let you play. And if you can shoot it, I want you to shoot it. Shoot that thing.
So you're giving a free hand and at the same time, you know, sticking to those defensive principles. Coach Mike, also for some context and the benefit of our viewers, so what's it like, you know, behind the scenes in college basketball in the state? Pretty much in local, we have an idea on how it is. You know, you get to a good high school, you get recruited, and then eventually exposure will give you some leverage to make it to the pros. But at the same time, it's a different landscape in the States. You got to start, you know, really young. You got to have, you know, when you go to the AAU and then you go to good high school programs and then you get recruited. What's it like in your experience coming from that standpoint? And how do these players get developed eventually if they want to make it to the NBA?
Yeah, so you know, to make it to the NBA, I mean, that's like a, you got to be in the top percentile of your skill. Like, you got to be in the top 1% of your shooting or top 1% athleticism, right? Everybody wants to make the NBA, but you, I mean, it's hard to do. There's 30 teams and they all got 15 players each and that's it, you know? So, but as far as the way, the landscape of college recruiting, it's, you try to identify talent. You see them a ton, not this summer, obviously, but high school and AAU, right? It's a big, big deal in the summer. All you're doing is watching these kids over and trying to identify talent. And then hopefully you're able to recruit them to your university. But right now it's a little different because they there's so many transfers, right? Like, a lot of our success has been built off high major transfers. Our best scorer is a Washington State transfer. One of our other bigs is a TCU transfer. These guys came from high major programs. So you have to be good at both, recruiting from the high school level and recruiting transfers. Somebody that wants to come and maybe get a little bit different opportunity here, like great education still, but you're getting an opportunity to play in Southern California, maybe at the mid-major level, and maybe get more minutes. Because the way you get to the NBA and you get to be a pro is you have to play. You got to play minutes on the court. So yeah, it's a different landscape a little bit than the Philippines, but not that much different. I think it's really similar. I know, like, Ateneo and those people there, those are like, Ateneo is what, that's like the Kentucky, right? They're like, they're recruiting, they're top recruits like to go there. And so very, a little bit similar. I've been out there a couple times, so.
Okay, so for my next question, Coach, I know that it's a monumental achievement for Filipinos to have this kind of position. Of course, you're the first Filipino-American, but can you tell us more on perspective on how is it like for Asians, for Filipino coaches in the basketball world in the States?
Yeah, I think, it's we're making progress. There's not many of us, you know. I there's one other full Division I Filipino assistant coach at Cal State Fullerton. He's actually in my league, our league, Anthony Santos. You know, there's just not many. There's not many, but they're coming. They're coming. You know, you're starting to see, especially like I've started to be introduced to them because I have the Asian Coaches Association, Oh, you know, on the women's side, there's a lot of Asian coaches, you know, but on the men's side, there's just not as many. So I feel like it's just kind of beginning. You're starting to see them bubble up and hopefully, you know, I provide some inspiration because of course my inspiration was Eric Spoelstra. You know, that's one of my idols. You know, he's one of my three coaching idols and I looked up to him ever since I was, you know, not that much, you know, younger than him, but I've looked up to him and then followed his journey and that's been a huge source of motivation for me. So hopefully I can provide some of that to others.
What were the challenges you had to go through about proving yourself and making it to achieve your dream?
Yeah, I think, you know, I never looked at, maybe others did, but I really just kept my focus and kept my head down. You know, it was kind of a miraculous thing that Kyle Smith responded to my email initially, you know what I mean? The one person who responded and that he took a chance. And like, even right now, like Tamika Smith-Jones, our athletic director, like taking a chance and moving forward with me and something, there's zero, you know, there's zero. Now I'm one, you know what I mean? So, and our UC Riverside and our chancellor to make this move. So the challenge is finding somebody that believes in you and to give you a chance, right? There's a lot of coaches out there that can do a good job. And so you just need somebody to believe in you and give you a chance. Obviously my former boss, David Patrick, has been humongous in setting this up and helping me get to this point and giving me the chance to coach the defense last year, be his right-hand man the last 2 years and grow. There's challenges, of course. You know, in the last 10 years, it's been a journey. You know, I've been at Columbia for 4 years, Campbell for three, San Francisco for a year, and moving and shaking and trying to prove that I can do it and coach and build relationships with players. And in college, recruiting is a big deal. So prove that I can recruit at the level that's necessary to win and succeed. But it's, you know, obviously it's a dream come true right now. So I'm excited.
We'll talk about resiliency, of course. And at the same time, you mentioned that coaching is a thankless job. When you win, it's about the players, but when you lose, it's about the coaches, right? And, you know, these are just one of the things that coaches go through. And during those 9 to 10 years, were there ever times that you felt that, you know, were there moments of despair? Were there moments of doubt? And I just want to ask you, Coach Mike, on how you got over those challenges. What was it in you that you learned in sports and, you know, at the same time to still go on and pursue that dream?
There were definitely challenges. You know, first of all, any loss or losing season is a challenge, right? It usually takes 3 to 4 years to build a program, and it took us 4 years at Columbia, took us 3 years at Campbell. Definitely doubt, you know, but I've been, luckily, my parents raised me to never quit, never give up. It's cliche, but it's definitely something that's been, it's something that I've always, the way that I've always lived my life, you know, when we, even during the real estate market, we were killing it in 04, 05, 06, like everybody else, we were like, I was rolling, you know, it was great. And 07, 08 hit, and I'd never run a company before and had, you know, we had 40 employees at the time, and dealing with that 2 year just bust, real estate bust, and managing through that, I think that kind of built some character and kind of got me to realize I could overcome some of these adversity, and that definitely lent itself and translated as a coach. You know, you don't make very much early on, and you're trying to find a way to make a career, but obviously, and that's not what it is. It's about, right? It's about, I just love coaching, right? It's my passion. And so, you know, when you get to chase your passion and you get to, I love going to coach between the four lines every day. It's exciting. So for me, that's kind of what's driven me, is that I love what I do.
Coach Mike, just a little bit of a side note. Your parents, your dad, your mom, I know that they came from the Philippines and worked for ABS-CBN. What was that story about?
They're so proud right now. They're so proud right now. If they were here, they're going to be so excited about this. They're like, make sure that they're the first interview. Like, so my parents like met when they were young. My dad, you know, worked in television his whole life. When he moved to this country, he worked at CBS Television, which is probably the biggest network in our country, in the United States. So, but he started at ABS-CBN. And I guess he met my mom there, and I guess she was like working behind the camera, running around, helping with something. And I guess got her attention, and somehow that turned into 5 kids here in America and raising us here in Los Angeles. And they are proud that I'm here with you right now, Migs. They're ecstatic. You know, nobody's prouder than my mom. And, you know, she's big on the Facebook now. So she's just so getting so many messages, and she's like, I didn't even know some of these people are coming out of the woodwork saying they're, you know, they're my family. And she's just so excited, so proud. So you know, there's nobody more proud than my mom and dad, and there's nothing that actually motivates me more than making them and my family proud.
All right, so lastly, Coach Mike, what is the first order of business for your team when, of course, you know, we get over COVID and everything goes back to the new norm?
Sure. Yeah. You know, the first thing was that our staff and myself, and we're working really, really hard. It's happened so fast. I can't even believe it's been 9 days since I was named head coach, but just making sure that we retained everybody. That was number one, you know? And so we had 2 team meetings this week via Zoom, and we had 100% retention, which was the most important part, because we have a really, really good team. A lot of credit to my predecessor, David Patrick, but we brought in, We have a great team. We have a chance to win this thing. We have a real shot at it. And so obviously the dream is to hopefully pass and get past this coronavirus, but we got to do it safely. And we're just kind of waiting for all the medical professionals, and we don't know what's going to happen there, but obviously we want to get back on the court. There's nothing I want more to be able to coach our guys and get them back on the court. And once we do, we're just going to get to work. They want to be back. You know, they're itching. They're chomping at the bit.
Lastly, Coach Mike, what is your message to your fellow Filipinos, especially in America, who aspire to be great coaches like you, to land these coaching jobs like you have?
You know what? Just believe in yourself, number one. And, you know, just never – don't – I really don't, I have blinders on, you know, no barriers should ever stop us. You know, we're great, great people. You know, we have We are great with relationships. You know, we were very jovial and funny. You know, like I love our culture, the best food in the world, in my opinion. But just keep punching away. Like the cream will rise to the top. And if you show a great attitude and a great work ethic, and you show an elite competency and passion at whatever you're doing, you're gonna succeed. There's no barrier that can stop us. So I'm proud to represent, you know, and I hope I make everybody proud in the Philippines and all the Filipinos here in America. And I hope I honor all of your guys' praise and best wishes.
All right, so Coach Mike Magpayo, head coach of UC Riverside. Coach, congrats. Thank you so much for joining us here on ANC.
Thank you, Migs. Thank you.